Majek Fashek's music, reggae genre of music. I love the fact that his music is very genuine and his lyrics are relatable. He sounds like someone who didn't do music because he wanted to do music, but he sounds like someone who music called him.
Majekodunmi Fasheke, popularly known as Majek Fashek, is a Nigerian reggae singer and guitarist. Fashek was born in Benin City, Nigeria, to an Edo mother and a Yoruba father. Fashek first gained national fame on a television show in the early 1980s as a member of Benin-based reggae group Jah Stix. His bandmates included Rasky Mono and Amos McRoy Gregg. They toured for many years with fellow reggae group The Mandators. Shortly after Jah Stix disbanded in 1988, he began a solo career and went on to become one of Africa's greatest reggae-influenced performers. His debut solo album, Prisoner of Conscience, released in 1988, sold more than 200,000 copies in Nigeria alone. His song, Send Down the Rain, was a hit, and he won 6 US-based P-Man Music Awards for it. After leaving Tabansi Records, he was signed to CBS Nigeria in the early 1990s before moving to Island Records' Mango imprint, a label more accustomed to marketing reggae internationally. His first album for the company included a cover version of Bob Marley's Redemption song.
Majekodunmi Fasheke, Fasheke Majek. Majek Fasheke to me, I grew up with just a little patience. That was the song I knew of Majek Fasheke. And my mother used to sing it to me because I was a very temperamental child. But anyways, yes, so Majek Fashek, to me, I think his music is very spiritual. Like, lyrics, very spiritual. There's so much soul, so much attitude, so much passion in it. Like, reggae for me, it's like very conscious music. Like, I feel like reggae should not be tampered with dirty substances, like dirty lyrics and stuff. Reggae is very spiritual. Majek Fashek stood for the spirituality in the genre of reggae music. And for a person, I think he's someone that doesn't, from what I see on TV and what I've read in the newspaper, I don't think he's much of a control person.
In 1990, Majek was signed to Interscope Records and released the critically acclaimed album Spirit of Love, produced by Little Steven Van Zandt. Flame Tree released the best of Majek Fashek in 1994, and he has recorded several albums for various labels since then, including Rainmaker for Tough Gong in 1997 and Little Patience for Coral in 2004.
Send Down the Rain was one of Majek Fashek's hit music compared to others. That was one song that really brought him out. I was a child at the time when Majek Fashek started singing. Yes, I was born in the 80s, yours. I attended one of his concerts he held in Port Harcourt, and it was almost midnight when he sang Send Down the Rain. And right immediately after the concert, there was a rain pour. That's what I'm beginning to suspect him. And very recently, he has come out and said he wants to be president. Majek, tell us what's going on. You have given your life to Christ. You are now... Anyway, well, very strong music at the time. It was everything every child wanted to dance to. We used to remember, Mama, Mama, yo, Papa, 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 yo, send down the rain. You get it? But after that night when I saw the rain fall, I said, no, Majek, you are questionable. Is it diabolical or it was a coincidence? You held your concert during rainy season. That kind of thing. But the music video was very beautiful, very wonderful. We saw him at the farmyard and then he was praying for rain. But we understand that the song was very significant because he was trying to, you know, call on Jah to send the rain on people's produce, you know, people's whatever it is that they laid their hands to do. The rain just signified prosperity, you know, that kind of thing, that you, when you need help from divinity and you want divinity to actually water it with the fruit of your labor. I believe that was why Majek Fashek sang that song, and it was pretty good. It was well received by the whole of Nigerians, and he was really one of the artists that was in, you know, competition with other artists who were doing other genre of music at the time. And you know, the likes of Raski Mono were walking in his stead, I'm just assuming. Because, it was also the same period when Raski Mono was coming out and other reggae artists with Philly. And then generations have come after and we are seeing the likes of Pato Rankin trying to, you know, make reggae genre of music acceptable in Nigeria, which is pretty good. So, well done, Majek, and the song Send Down the Rain was actually it. It sent down indeed blessings on Nigerians.
When will the African people unite? When will the African people come together? This unity among the children every day. That is unity among the African people. Ya yo, na na cha na na do. Anachi nati bongo. Ya yo, shana na shana na do. Nati nati bo bo, shana shana na do. Bibombe, sabaru bare, na na shana na do. Sabaru baro, sada bare, na na shana na do. When will the black people unite? When will the black people come together? The white people getting stronger every day. And there is unity among the black people. Yayo, shandana, shandana, no. Anati nati bobo, shana na do. Ya yo, shana shana na do. Anati nati bobo, shana shana na do. Si bombe, sabaru barop, shana shana na do. Sabaru barop, shada barep, shana shana na do.
you know when you're on that level, you just have to, the lights are just the Bob Marley. You're so, you know, and you have to cover your eye from it. Anyway, I think Bob Marley to Majek, like everybody has a mentor, role model in the industry, and Bob Marley was the pioneer of reggae music in Africa. But Majek Fashek was our father, our go-to father for reggae in Nigeria. Yes. His influence on today's Nigerian artists, let me tell you, is the dreadlocks. All those fake dreadlocks everybody's doing, that's Bob Marley's influence today, and the excuse for substance taking.
Fashek is one of the increasing number of African artists to be drawn to music of the Caribbean, specifically reggae rather than indigenous hybrids such as Fuji, Juju or Highland. Having grown up in a fervently religious and musical family, he was exposed to the imported songs of Bob Marley at an early age, alongside the innovations of local stars such as Fela and Ikulaku.
You know, I would like to say that the way Bob Marley was to Jamaicans and lovers of raga music, and the way Lucky Dube, you know, was to South Africans, I believe that Majek Fashek was same to Nigerians. And so, if I want to relate what it is that the late Bob Marley did in the reggae music genre to what Majek Fashek was doing, I would feel like it's the same reggae spirit, you know, it's the same reggae genre of music, and it was acceptable, and I mean, that's what it is.
After a good season of achievement and fame, something happened. From good to bad, bad to worse. Different headlines started popping up. The iconic singer and guitarist who took the Nigerian music scene by storm and churned out several hit bangers that made people tag him a musical prophet got into misuse of alcohol, marijuana and other hard drugs.
I'm skinny, so I don't like when people say the skinny guy. I think it's always worse. I think it's more of like a machete, and I felt bad. But anyways, I think it really affected the lack of control. I read or heard that he's more of an alcoholic. You know, I read a biography from one of his autobiographies. His friend was talking about him, and the guy was almost crying in the interview. Like, he was practically crying that they tried everything to help Majek.
After Fela's death, a vacuum was created for the disenfranchised Nigerians. There was a need for a voice of the people. Majek could have been that replacement because he had the charisma, the charm, the language, the style, and the personality. He's a people's person, but the story is not the same anymore.
I mean, who does music in the world and doesn't take substance? Unless you're gospel, unless you're alternative soul. But if you're doing reggae, come on, there's got to be ganja on the side. There is no reggae, no ganja. If just in case you don't know what ganja is, Google. Okay, ganja is weed. I mean, look, reggae artists everywhere all over the world, it's nothing new. We've seen it, we know it. There are a lot of reggae artists that promoted such substances. And I think very unfortunate Majek Fashek fell into these devices. And you don't forget that music in the 80s, 90s was sellable because there were international record companies that were signing in our Nigerian artists. And if you have international record labels signing our Nigerian artists, that's a lot of money. That is lots of money. So you find out that artists, when they have lots of money, they can't really control themselves. They start, you know, going into substance abuse. And that was the same thing to me for Majek Fashek. I know, yeah, there were rumors about him roaming the streets of Lagos, da-da-da-da-da, and like I earlier said, him waking up one morning and wanting to be president, those are just the influences of drugs. But it doesn't change the legacy that Majek has set in this country.
All being good, Majek is back now and more determined to work his way into the good books of Nigerians, determined to give his once successful career one more shot.
And that's why I believe that my reggae fans out there are praying so hard that he comes back, he bounces back and comes back on stage, because Majek, whenever he sang with his soul. He sang with all of him, you know, and we want to see that same guy. It might be too late, he might be too old, but I think that the best way to bounce back is collaborations. If we see that the likes of Pato Rankin and other reggae artists that are springing up are doing good, that's your target, man. That's your target. Come back to life, call these people, go into the studio, and you can be assured that we can do the remix of Send Down the Rim again. If you want to send down Brimstone, we will buy it. If you want to send fire, we are going to buy it. As long as it's Majek Fashek. Get it? Yeah. Majek Fashek, do I think that you can actually bounce back? Look into my eyes, watch this video. Hey, you can get back on track, trust me. Because I was one of the people who grew up listening to your song, and every other Nigerian out there who is doing music definitely grew up listening to your genre of music, listen to your song. So I believe that you can get back on track. I believe that you can explode. And then again, you're signed to international record label. They are making money off you. There's something we call royalties. And you know that these international labels are well organized. So So go ask for your money, tell them you want it, and go into the studio and do something great. And trust me, West Africa, Africa, and the rest of the world will buy your music again. Majek Fashek, we're wishing you all the best. We want you back on track. We want you alive together again, because you're still the papa and the don of reggae music.
All being good, Majek is back now and more determined to work his way into the good books of Nigerians, determined to give his one successful career one more shot.
Positivity from Majek Fashek, yes, anything can happen. You know, anything can happen. And I think Majek should just, you know, brace up, forget it. We're going to forgive you because of the awesome talent, the awesome blessing given to us. Because I really want to see, I want to witness a Majek Fashek concert so that I can tell my children, did you know I went for a Majek Fashek concert? I can sing this in this patient. Yeah, I believe something good can still come out. So that I can train these people that think they're doing reggae in Nigeria.
Majek Fashek, come a little closer. Like, seriously, I need to talk to you like son to father. Yes. You have sent the rain on us and it has set the pace for us. Get it? So we want to now send you our own rain. I don't know what it's going to be, but hey, look into my eyes. You can actually come back to the limelight. It's not the end of you, just like the names that you bear signify a lot. You can actually come back to life. So we're watching out for you, Majek. Call me, I'll manage you. I'll try.